We are holding in Seif, Kuta Alochis. Here is Bichas HaShachar. Alocha Hey, we are holding by Seif Einvov, 76. So, the Kaddish Baruch Hu has created nature in such a way that the tzaddikim have a koyach to change nature with their prayer. That's one koyach. And he gave the sitracha, you know, a commensurate koyach to do, you know, keneged, you know, to do a kshofim like a but ultimately the koyach of the kedusha is stronger. Even the warlocks of Mitzrayim had to admit at the end that it was Etzba Elokim, was the finger of Hashem. There's a certain principle embedded in this. And he says like this, V'hine mikol ha-ma'asiyos ha-neiros ha-elu v'cha-elu. From all these incredible stories and such stories, mikol ma she-mevoah b'sifre ha-kodesh mizeh, and everything that the Sifre Kodesh retell about this particular inyan, אנו רואים גודל כוח הבחירה שנוסון השם יסבורך לאודם בזה האוילם המייסן. You can see the greatness of the כוח of choice that the Kodesh Baruch Hu gave a person in this world. והעיקר בחירה על ידי שאלים רצוינו. The main concealment and the thing that enables the Bechir is the fact that Hashem has concealed his Ratzon. Ve'enu magale soydoi, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu does not reveal his secret kim la'avodo v'nevim to his servants, the prophets, aroidfim u'misyagim la'asig ratzonoi, that chase and are working very, very hard to find out and ascertain exactly what it is that Hashem wants. ואלו הנביאים והצדיקים האמיתיים, they reveal the רצון of Hashem על ידי תפילות המקדושים. This is how they reveal the רצון of Hashem. As we learned also in Likut HaMaran, that the tefillah is the thing that enables the Torah, you know, the seichel to learn the Torah, to flow. Because, you know, is Eden is the tefillah, and the Gan is the Torah, if you remember from Torah Ches. The Torah, the tefillah is the thing that reveals, it gives us the mental capacity to understand the Torah, and to understand, which basically is to understand what Hashem wants. Shall they say that through that the incredible tefillah, hem oisim moifsim v'oisus neiros ba'olam, they do tremendous miracles in the world. והעיקר הוא משה רבנו שהוא רמן של כל הנביאים. The main one is משה רבנו, who is the Rebbe of all the נביאים, שעשה אויסוס ומופסים נוראים בעולם, that made tremendous miracles in the world, אשר לא נשמעו ולא נראו בכל הארץ, that have never been heard of, you know, have never been seen before or since in the entire land. As it is said, אני הקדר והגודל הזה, who has such an incredible happens that have, you know, has ever happened. וכל מה שעשה, and everything he did, הכל על הדעה היה על ידי תפילה. Everything he did through תפילה. כמו שכוסו ויצק אל השם, and he screamed to השם. וכן באלישה, and the same thing happened with אלישה. By the way, I'm sorry to disturb you. Did I leave the key in the door? Just check it out for one second. I beg your pardon for 1 minute. Sorry about that. You don't lock the door. Just what?
I just closed it.
Just close it. Okay. Seder. Yeah. And the same thing is with Elisha Anovi, Ve'Elisha kol Madovid betfila oda. With everything that Elisha did, he did with tfila. Ve'imken, aval imken kvar ya mitzvot al abechira. If everything would be just open and so simple, you know, the koyach of the bechira would be cancelled out. Ve'imbatel kol ha'olam shenivra rak bishvil abechira. The law was created only for the sake of a bechira. Ba'ken kol yimei kirim ha'olam be'echach she'a bechira. That's why as long as the world exists, there has to be bechira. ועל כן בדורכי נפלאו איסר וסבורך נתן כך גם עשית רעך עדי צבא הקודש ברוך הוא in a wondrous way that he gave courtesy to Racha also, you know, to do, you know, samoifsim lefi shor, you know, it's ade kshofim v'shem ezatuma, through, you know, witchcraft and names the tuma. והגודל שבהם היה בילם, the biggest one that knew how to do it was בילם הראשו. שלקוח בפיו כנגד מוישה בקדושו ומשם נמשכים כל הכפירס רחמון לצן. This is where all the heresies are coming. And he says, וכל תרוסם של כל הכפירים ועוד אזור שבדור עשו שוינים נמשך מזה. All the mistake of all the heretics and all those that served over the Zohar in the first Doris was from that. They were not, you know, stupid imbeciles like the people think. Bifrat Rashem, especially the heads like Balak and Bilam and Chatum and Mitzrayim and the wise men of Bnei Kedem. הכל תאוסם היה, their mistake was שאמרו שיכולים להמשיך רצוינו כמו שעושה כל אחד. They had the American system that they felt that it could be whatever they wanted to be. They can be מושך דרוצה מהקודש ברוך הוא to fit whatever that they want. The idea was not to be mevatel, to annihilate their own, to sacrifice their own רוצן. To the Ratzon Hashem, but they figured, you know, they can take the energy of Ratzon Hashem and pull it down to do what they want. It's written in books because they used to say Shem Otzum Dulos and the Kadosh Baruch Hu is so awesome and so great, so that he is too exalted to run the world, you know, by himself. So they came into these foolish ideas that they have to serve the intermediary, the runs the world for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that in such a way they will be able to use the energy from HaKadosh Baruch Hu and to lead it the way they want. And the world runs on the principle that the way that a person wants, Mishamayim, that's the way they lead him. And that's why Gdol HaEtzo, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, has faked them out and he gave them koyach that they will be able to do, to accomplish things. Be'uvda ve'milula, you know, in deed and in speech. Va'ikar ve'milula, the main thing in the speech, because the dibur has a tremendous koyach. Until Bilam, they used to go in the way of Bnei Kedem, as it is said, min haram en cheni bolak ma'arei Kedem, from the mountains of Kedem, from the mountains of old, from the people of old, and the Zohar Kodesh said that they had the koyach to bless or curse entire nations, and it'll come true. And this is the thing that they made mistake: the Kiilu Kodesh Baruch Hu doesn't have any ratzon; just whatever you want, you can do. Validei Zeh, they didn't want to admit that the Shem Yisboach has picked out, has chosen Am Yisrael. If Kodesh Baruch Hu doesn't have a Rotzen, and you can choose and do whatever you want, so what pitam Kodesh Baruch Hu chose Am Yisrael? Hey, that's all messed up. That means he wants. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants his nation, and he wants his Yireim, you know, the people who serve him. Even though they saw such tremendous moves that Moshe Rabbeinu did, you know, they say, you know, we can also do it. You know, we can also perpetrate these kind of things. That's why they say that each one can bring down the Ratzon the way he wants. He says, we also come on them in a person has a koyach in his mouth. What's the koyach of Moshe Rabbeinu? In his mouth? Yet problema. We have person, he also have mouth, big mouth like mountain. Yes, we bring him. Yes. But the truth is that them mice were absolutely nothing. Koma say, Utoim ki kol ha-goyim ki ha-i negdoi ve-ein shu le-evdel, and there's no measurements to the difference between the moifsim of Moshe Rabbeinu and the tzaddikim that came after him, and Maisa Bilam and the warlocks of Mitzrayim. Is a kiatam ha-om le-olam Hashem, u-le-olam yadcha alai el-yoyno. You are forever higher, Hashem, and your hand always overpowers. And it is said in Dvaro that vis-a-vis the maisim of the tzaddikim, there's always maisim for Shoim, like Pinchas, you know, flew in the air, Bilam also flew in the air, but Sof Pinchas had defeated Bilam and dropped him on the sword and he died. Now, one of the things that need to be emphasized over here, like about the Indian of Bechira, sorry. There's actually two types of Bechira. There's a Bechira, you know, for whether you want to do the Otzer HaKadosh Baruch Hu or not, consciously. There's Moshe Rabbeinu, Baruch Hashem, there are all the tzaddikim, we have the Shulchan Aruch, we have Baruch Hashem Mishneh Berurah, we have Poskim, you know, there's no problem, you don't know what to do, you pick up the phone, you call, you know, Rav Kornfeld, Rav Hage, or whatever it is you want, he passes for you, you know what to do, and finish. But if this would have been, you know, the only bechira, then basically it's like it's a black and white kind of thing. Either you do it or you don't do it. But within it, you know, life is much more complicated than just, you know, do you want to do what Allah says or not? I mean, in itself, it all starts, you know, with Allah. You know, and that's, as the Rebbe says, you know, you can take Lekuto Maran and you can bend it any which way you want. He says, as long as you don't move, you don't veer, you know, even from a small Seif Shulchan Aruch. That's point number one. But when you come to subjugate your Ratzon to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, there are many finer points which are not really written in Shulchan Aruch. What do you do with Gaiva? What do you do when you daven Shmoneh Esrei and you like really get into it and suddenly you're thinking that other people are looking at you? And they're probably thinking that, wow, this guy's sounding like really nice. And you realize that you're missing the point, but you can't get out of it. Or when you're davening, suddenly Avodah Zarah stands in front of your eyes. And you can't shake it. Or suddenly, you know, people can get these weird ideas, you know, subtly, you know, men can have these ideas that, you know, he likes his neighbor. She looks to him that should be his wife. Never spoken to her. Maybe he speaks to her, but he doesn't know anything. But it gets into his head, and it gets in like a virus. It just doesn't go out. And you don't know what to do. And he's all this demyonis. He wishes Alavai his wife jumped off the balcony, so it'll be already over and done with, and he'll be able to marry her. And he knows that this is a shtus, but there's nothing he can do about it. And there are periods in the life of men that things become very difficult. In his 40s, you know, this midlife crisis, you know, when suddenly, you know, you open up your eyes and this is like, whoa, you know, I don't want to be, you know, this Alta, whatever it is. I want to buy myself a motorcycle. You know, I want to do things. I want to live. You know, I want to just. What do you do? What do you do when you get embarrassed? You know, when you feel pain, what do you do when you're faced with all kinds of situations that don't have these neat little answers in books and stuff? Now, you have a choice here. You can say, listen, when it's Torah, there's halacha, I do Torah halacha. The rest, that's mine, leave me alone. Alright? But we have all kinds. We have Musar, we have this, we have that. It's like, the ways of avoiding Hashem, to find what does Hashem want from me at any given moment, is not only more complicated, but it's a lot more ambiguous. And the person needs a lot of work. A lot of hadracha from the tzaddikim, a lot of chaverim that will speak to him, and he keep him in siyais with them, because everybody goes through the same things. You know, and everybody, you know, you need to learn the secrets of the trade, you know, like what do you do when this happens, when that happens, you know. It's like I remember many years ago, maybe like 35 years ago, we're davening Yom Kippur, Bnei Brak, the Kailul, and it's like, and I was like really shaken. And I was walking with the Simcha Balev. We were walking home. And I told him, you know, I don't know if I believe. You know, I got into my davening, and suddenly I didn't know where I was. So he goes, Boker Tov Yetzirara, welcome. Start. He didn't say much. But he didn't have to.
Even back then?
What?
Even back then?
No. About this, he didn't say much. But by telling this to him, I mean, the thing is that I could have just kept it inside myself, where it would fester and it would grow, and I would think that I'm like the worst person on earth, and then I start doubt myself, and, you know, it just really get out of hand. Instead, I just told him what was going on, Well, he told me this is what it is. And the rule is that monsters grow in the dark. During the day, you know, all the monsters under the beds. You know, that every kid knows that if you're lying in your bed, you're safe. But if you have like a finger out of the bed, yeah, then you're in mortal danger from the monsters that live under the bed at night. You know? The minute that you take these machshavas out and you put in broad daylight, you see him with a sadness, what's the big deal? This whole inyon is the inyon of the Bechira. It should be like this, it should be like that, it should be like this, it should be like that. This whole inyon is the inyon of the tzaddikim and the aces of the tzaddikim. And a person cannot serve a Kadosh Baruch Hu on his own unless he is like, he's Rabbeinu. You know, and even Rabbeinu said that if he had somebody, you know, with him, they would tell him, like, you know, shtagzach, you know, be strong, he would have, like, really, really got chizik from it. That's Rabbeinu, okay? Today is the Yotzer of Rabbeinu. Rabbeinu Nachum ben Feige. And I saw this tremendous sicha from Rabbi Levi Yitzchak Bender. And he says, when Moshe Rabbeinu came to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the first thing HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells him, you know, is Shal Na'alecha Mal Reglecha. You know, shed off the shoes off your feet. The Zohar Kadosh says, what he told him is, shed the body of the snake. Shed the skin of the snake from you. You see, after Adam and Risha and Chava, you know, as they say, after the episode in the garden.
Say with an accent.
Yes, which is episode, you know, which is a fantastic English way of describing anything, you know, like. After the episode in the garden, so Kadosh Baruch Hu made the levushei or a garment of skin to Adam and Chava. That means that our bodies, as it's called mishcha dechivya, it's called the snake of the skin, of the snake. Sorry. The skin of the snake, not the snake of the snake, okay. I'm sorry, it's early in the morning. Anyhow, be that as it may. And we are all, the Mishchad Chivya, I'm sorry, I apologize. Everybody, it's okay. No alarm. The Mishchad Chivya is the skin that we pull over ourselves, the perspective we lock ourselves in through our meisim, the way that we behave. That's the mishchad chivya. The first thing HaKadosh Baruch Hu told Moshe Rabbeinu, already says Moshe, he says with that there was no psik, you know, in Avram. So there is a comma between the first Avram and the second Avram, which means that after Kodesh Baruch Hu called Avram Avinu the first time, when he called him the second time, was already a different Avram Avinu, because the very calling of Hashem has already changed him. But Moshe Rabbeinu is Moshe without a comma in between them, because Moshe Rabbeinu was good, was already in that Madrega to begin with, and even him, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, take off the body the skin of the snake from you. And he says, and we're coming to such a Rebbe. We're coming to Rabbeinu. He says, the first thing we need to do is take off the skin of the snake, of the Bet Meisim. So why don't we do it? He says, because either we don't believe, or we just don't realize who Rabbeinu is. We don't realize in front of whom we're standing. We have no clue, you know, who is Rabbeinu and what does it mean to stand before him. Okay, you know, we go to Umar, we go to this, we go to that, this is very good, this is wonderful. You say Tikkun HaKlal, yeah, Baruch Hashem. You said a little, Baruch Hashem. But if we had any kind of inkling of who is Rabbeinu HaKadosh, the first thing that we would do, even if it's the beginning of the Avodah, would be to take off the filthy clothes. To take off the filthy meisim. Because, see, the thing is like this. In Torah Chafal, the Rebbe speaks about the seven candles of the menorah, which are the ears and the eyes and the nose and the mouth, which represents the Emunas Chachomim and your Shemaim and what you look at and what you say. The Inyan of Sukkos that we are standing in right now is, especially with the Na'anuim of the Lulav, is that we bring down the Ashpoas, the spirituality that we got during Rosh Hashanah, Elul, Rosh Hashanah, Sesem Etshuva, which is, you know, on the theoretical level, we bring them down. I mean, Arizal says, you know, when you shake the lulav, the idea is to shine the light of the chasadim in the das, and to take that light that is in the das, the chasadim, in the level of das, there are chasadim. And the lights of that das is supposed to, with the lulav, draw them down and shine them onto the esron, which is the malchus. That's what Arizal says. Basically, what it means is that you take the illuminations, the spiritual illuminations that you got during all these holy days, from beginning of Elul, and you bring it down to this world, Lemaisa. And the moshel for it, the euphemism for it, is that on Yom Kippur, the drop of the seed for the year is complete, and it's being brought into the sukkah, and the sukkah represents the womb. And Shmini Atzeres, the West called Shmini Atzeres, that Atzeres is a tipo, it stops the drop, and it can grow. And then it gives birth to Tzimchas Torah, it gives birth to the Torah. The Schach, it also explains at great length, is a filter. It's basically a filter from the deus of this world, the opinions of this world. Because we need to understand the way we are is that we are totally bound, completely and totally bound, by our perspective. Somebody who comes from a Chassidish home, you know, from home, and he sees the people dancing in Pushkin Square, to, you know, trance music. And he says, like, what is this? However, somebody who comes from Tel Aviv, I look at somebody with your shemaim, is going around, he's not looking, and he thinks this guy's a fool. I mean, what's he going, you know, covering his eyes? What's the... Your perspective, it's not something that you can see things from other perspectives. You can't do that. You're locked in to your perspective. That's the only thing that you can see. Now I'm making sure I didn't bring you coffee. You see it. I should have looked. I'm like, yeah, I know. We're gonna show here. Let's show them that this is the empty cup. This is my fault. Sorry, I apologize. The formation of the perspective is done by who do you believe, what you're looking at, what you're afraid of, and what you say. This is the Anon HaKovod. This is the seven directions, the seven walls, you know, the six are in the middle of the sukkah. If you don't listen to Lashon Hara, if you don't listen to things you shouldn't, if you don't listen to what the pundits say about what the news mean, what they don't mean, and what the politically correct morality means, with all the garbage and the filth and everything, and you listen to Chachamim, to the point that, as Rashi says, you know, but and you should not deviate from what they say left to right, even if they tell you on the left that it is right, that you think that is the opposite, Bimavatl Yodas. That's the tikkun of those nine. You know, don't look at what you're not supposed to look. When you look at it, you think that nothing happens to you. But what it does is it calls your shemaim on the spot. On the spot. And whenever a person utters a lie, L'tovas Atzmon, for his own benefit, it changes him. It makes him into a liar. And Yir Shamayim, which is the tikkun of the nose, is not only you know, the fact that you shouldn't do things, you know, that obviously the Kodesh Baruch Hu does not want, but more than just that. Sometimes you get into situations like, you know, the buddies are going drinking or something is going on, and it hasn't happened yet. It hasn't happened yet, but you realize that, yeah, could happen. You know, it's like, or like, before people start, you know, when there's a scuffle, you know, whatever it is, and it's like, you know, I don't know, a tailgate party or whatever it is, and you know, there's going to be a beating, you know, whatever it is. Before there's a beating, there's a smell that something could happen. You know, there's this, in Hebrew, it's called yesh matzav. You know, there's a situation. There's a possibilities. You know, it's. The ground is fertile to positive development in that direction. It could be anything. That is the last stop, the last point you can say no. Because once you go over there, once you go over that, you're done. They say, I don't understand. You know, it's just like from one thing, you do understand. You just chose when you realized that there is the smell, that there is something is going on. You chose to disregard it. Because it's going to be fun, you know, it's going to be happening, whatever. Hashem should help us. To please, to shut Kamara.